Hello everybody, and welcome to this tutorial, how to model this ice cart in Shapr3D. In this episode, we will start with a very bare-bone design. Like you see here, we only have the metal frame and the components, and then we have to build everything that goes around it. And then we will end with adding materials inside the visualization tool to create a beautiful product presentation like this one. The raw file is shared with you, so please feel free to download it so you can follow this demonstration. And with all that said, let's get going. So here we are. Before we get started, let's take a look at the scene. As you can see, this contains all the metal hardware and the ice chilling box in the inside. And we also have a human figure for scale representation. Everything is nicely sorted into individual groups, so we can select those or turn those off. And now we would like to model the metal siding, the countertop, and the roof based on what we have inside this design. So how do we start? One way is to select this nice top face. This is actually a clean wooden board, and from that I can create an offset. And with this construction plane, I can project certain edges onto it, like in your sketch. So I select, in this case, just only these rounded edges. There. And then the construction plane and project. There we are. Beautiful. Now, the sketch I can select and isolate. And all I have to do left is fill in the missing lines. Perfect. Now this is exactly, if you go to your top view, the order parameter. Beautiful. I don't want anything to move, so I will double tap a sketch element, select the whole sketch, and say lock. Let's go to the sketch one more time and isolate it. This is very clean. So the first thing I will do is work on my tabletop. You see how I extruded the sketch up, moved it up, there we are. And then I can select the lower face. Here we have the metal brackets. It should sit perfectly on these metal brackets. And then with the replace face command, I make this move down, be perfectly flush. Amazing. We can move this one down, and we see based on the snapping, this should be 4 centimeters material thickness. This construction plane we can now delete, we don't need it anymore. Let's continue refining this the countertop. Here we select this and then the socket for the one telescope arm, the other telescope arm, and then the ice box. Go subtract, and we would like all these pieces to be removed from the countertop geometry, including keep removed bodies, because the magenta pieces, the cyan pieces, we would like to keep. Click done. Very nice. This now we can hide, and these elements are the leftovers. There you see those. Those we would like to simply delete. And let's rename actually this body into counter top. Very good. You see, this was actually pretty easy. What do we do now? The roof. That's actually also quite simple. It's also a really good exercise to show you how we can design something around movable pieces. Here I will go to this front view, and then I will double tap this and move this down. Let's not select anything. Turn on section view. Now I can see where this piece is and I can move it down. I have the grid snapping turned on. I also worked cleanly with the grids, so this makes moving elements up and down very, very easy. Double tap on this to select the object, move it down there. Look at this. Now I have exactly the distance between the countertop and this surface, 12 centimeters. I can, for example, turn off the section view, select the sketch, isolate it, extrude this up 12 centimeters. And now I have to move this up a little bit. There we are. Turn the isolation off. The whole piece I can simply move down. There. Very good. Perfect. And there you can see how this starts to intersect with the other elements. We need to add more material. We would like to have a roof that is 2 centimeters thick. So we select the top face and make this 14. Beautiful. Then double tap, isolate, select the lower face. We can shell this now. Let's give this 0.5 centimeter of material thickness. But this also means that this is now 0.5 centimeter. So we select the inner face under the roof and then change this to 2 centimeters. And go to a front view. Show everything again, deselect everything, section view, double tap the roof, and then we just move this up to where it should be. Yeah, there it is. Perfect. You see, that's how easy this was. Then we can move this back up. There we are. And we will move the lower telescope arm up. Perfect. Okay, very nice. Maybe a last detail, we can select this edge and this edge and this edge and give those a nice 0.5 centimeter rounding. Okay, that's good. Beautiful. So from here now, how do we continue and create a quick visualization of the metal siding? It's going to be a little bit complicated. Is this is flat and this is round and this is flat. How do we do this? Let me show you. We select the sketch, isolate it again. Go to your top view, go into sketch edit, go to loop select for offset. And then this is actually 2 centimeters. Why do I know this is 2 centimeters? Let me show you something interesting. When we select this face and this face, you see at the bottom it says 2 centimeters. And this is really just the horizontal distance, not the diagonal distance. So that's the reason why I knew this. So we can go back to isolate the sketch, double tap after selecting the sketch. And now I need few more lines. One there, one here. And I need one there. These are my long corner and short side. How do we do the mirror parts? Check this out. I draw from this midpoint a line and then this line I move away. And I do the same here. From the midpoint, I draw a line and move this line away. These lines are going to function as my mirror axis later. Very good. So now I can go into this view, turn this on. Then I can select this, extrude this down, and I know this is here 27, and then it starts cutting. So 27, very good. Now I can select these two, bring this down, minus 27, very good. And then select these three top faces. Now we look from the bottom and say, match this to this height by using the replace face command. Just have to be careful with the correct association. So you see our three surfaces we would like to match over the target surface. Done. There we are. Pretty nice. So look at this. We can select these three, go to isolate, There we are. So now very quickly, we would like to create something that looks like folded mesh, a folded metal box. So that means we would like to have a structure similar like this. So a 2 millimeter material thickness, but not really sharp edges. How can we do this nicer? So if we talk to a client or an engineer, they understand what we would like to do. So I will select this piece and unhide everything or unisolate and then isolate this piece. Now I will select this front face. That's a little trick. Then these corners and then this corner and this corner. By selecting the face, check out what happens the moment when I click chamfer. You see all these edges are selected. So all this, I will round by 0.5 centimeters. Very good. And then the inside, I shall 0.2. And from the outside, this looks much nicer, particularly these rounded edges in the material visualization really will look nice because they will create nice highlights. Unisolate everything. And we do the same with these two. Also here, select the faces. Then we can select all these four edges. So you see, I don't have to work on piece by piece. I can do the same command on multiple pieces. There we are. Very good. Chamfer 0.5. There we go. Fillet, I mean. And then the inside faces. We select shell 0.2. Unisolate. There we are. Beautiful. Look at this. This looks actually pretty believable. Yeah. So how do we now create the missing parts? Select this by double clicking. So this one rounded corner side. Select then this line in the sketch. And look at this on the left side. In the predicted tool selection, we have mirror. Mirror, keep original, very good. Same with this one. And then double tap, double tap, double tap, and then we will select this line. And okay, very good. So with just only one sketch, you saw we modeled all these individual pieces fairly fast. Before we bring everything into the visualization tool to give materials onto the objects, we want to give everything a logical name. And these are our sides. I will drag this into a folder altogether with the last piece. We'll call this sides. Very good. There we are. Let's hide the sketch. Beautiful. Then let's go to the visualization tool. I can double tap onto an object that selects it. On the right side, now you see this is the default standard material. I would like to change this to be ABS glossy. Click onto properties, and then I can change the color. Very nice. I can double tap the countertop. Do the same. ABS glossy, properties, and then we change it to a nice white color. I would like to very quickly give this colored ABS material also to the metal sides. So I can go to my object browser, select all the sides. Then I click change and select the ABS material. And you see how quickly we gave that material to a lot of objects. And the same we will do with horizontal, vertical, and icebox, the telescope tubes, the big frame, and the wheel, and all those we will give and like a polished aluminum look. Very nice. Okay, now this should be glass. So change, we can go to all materials and then select glass and select glass thick. Here, this should be the ABS plastic white. So double tap onto each object, change, and select the glossy ABS. Also, the tires, we will give an individual material. This should be synthetic rubber properties. And we want to change this from pitch black to kind of like a dark gray, because there's not really a super black material we can produce. Yeah, and there we nearly are. Let's go to the environment. I would like to change the look a little bit more. Select gradient, then click on the cog icon. I have here this predefined material color. And now we can also rotate the light source. So maybe something like this, move this around like there. This looks really good. Beautiful. The person's nicely in the shadow. And then we can create a nice image by clicking capture. And that's it.